everybody. How's everybody doing today on this fantastic Monday morning? Hope everyone had a wonderful weekend. Happy Mother's Day to all the mothers out there. These are mothers with actual human children. I'm very, very specific about that. If I offend anybody, my apologies. It's just the way it is. I wanted to talk about something pretty serious today. My morning podcast, Wake the Fuck Up with Jeff Show. I usually do single topic stuff. I tend to rant a little bit, get a little bit out of control, but maybe you don't like my delivery, but the information is correct. My name is Jeff Gelman of Solid Canine Training, and this is the Wake the Fuck Up with Jeff Show. I stream every Monday through Friday, 8 a.m. to 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Sometimes it doesn't go till 9. All depends on what the show is about, the amount of questions that I get. This is an audience participation show. Then I also do the What Would Jeff Do Show, and that's every Wednesday and Friday at 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. I do that with Joel, and then I also do a Zoom Q&A on Tuesdays. Is for our Patreon members, and Patreon's only $10 a month. I do four of those a week, and that's face-to-face, voice-to-voice. And the whole goal of this is other than Patreon, which is $10 a month, everything else is free, along with our 50,000 posts on social media, tons of free information that we have out there, and lots and lots and lots of helpful information to make dramatic difference in people's lives. I'm going to read an email, and this is not to shame the owner. I'm not going to actually say the owner's name. Nobody's going to know who this person is. So if you're listening, I'm going to call you later, but don't. I'm not doing this to shame you. I'm doing this because folks need a massive wake-up call. They need a massive wake-up call. And I'm also streaming live on Rumble. So join my Rumble channel right now. I go to Rumble questions usually sometimes beforehand. If you don't know my Rumble channel, it's www.rumble.com/C-Clients-Customer-Solid-Canine-Training. But join my Rumble channel. I'd appreciate it because one of these days I'm going to be streaming probably exclusively on Rumble, as well as my brand new podcast, Common Sense with Common Sense Talk with Jeff Gelman. And that'll be a whole other thing. It's got nothing to do with dog training whatsoever. It's a whole different thing. It's a whole different format. It's a separate channel, and I'll be doing that. So I wanted to talk about this weekend's fuck up with our platform for our sale, and we are extending it till Tuesday night because so many people couldn't take advantage of the 29% off, which is a humongous savings, a huge, huge savings. We are in the process of our online platform for our courses, switching over to a new platform, which we have more control over, but it takes about a month to do. So if you tried to buy a course this weekend at 29% off and it did not work, what you can do is you can still go to academy.solidcaninetraining.com, still go there. And at the end, when it asks you for a code, put in happy 29. That should work. It should work. It's been working all morning. So hopefully it'll work. But I don't know what's going on with our existing platform, but it's not doing well. So Tony is working around the clock. He's got to transfer all of our content over, which takes a while, a long while. We also added two new bundles. So now there's four bundles, and at 29% off, you save a ton of money. There's a 5-course bundle, and I think that there's another 3 or 4-course bundle on there as well. It's going to run till Tuesday midnight Eastern Standard Time, which I believe is the 16th. Really, really excited about that. So jump onto Rumble, join that, because a lot of stuff is going to be announced on Rumble. Even if you don't buy our course, sign up on our mailing list, because a lot of stuff goes on our mailing list. There's just so many great things happening. Joelle did not come home last night because of her flight. She's already stuck again in Providence, delayed again. And we're not sure when she's going to be back. Hopefully today she'll be back. What else? This is what I want to talk about. I'll get to your questions afterwards. Don't worry about that. The introduction to this post, which is a little bit in your face, but it needs to be said. The thing is, I say what everybody's thinking, but nobody says it. And I don't say this to shame anybody. I'm pro-client. I want you to be successful. I don't want your dog to die. But your dog is going to die if you don't straighten this thing out. And I can fix it. I can eliminate your problems. So the description of today's show is, I'm going to read it again. With so many folks struggling with your dog being aggressive, stop telling me how much you love your dog and how your dog is smart, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. Who gives a shit? Your dog is going to die if you don't do anything about it. This is pro owner, so let's get going. All right. I got an email. I'll be talking to these clients tonight for the first time, today for the first time. And if you're listening, I'm not trying to upset you, offend you, or shame you. Nobody knows who you are. They've got a 4-year-old German Shepherd dog and their resource guards. They've been following me for years. They're on a lot of my platforms. I don't believe they've ever purchased anything from me, but they follow me. The dog has bitten their kids 6 to 8 times. They rehome the dog. And after the first day of it being rehomed to just a house with just a single male, it bit the male, and then the dog came back. They don't want to turn the dog into a shelter because it will be killed. You are right. It will be killed. Okay. And you care about the dog and you love the dog. Of course you do. Of course you love the dog. I don't blame you. This is the thing. When a client writes in that their dog has bit their children 6 to 8 times, supposedly unprovoked, and it's not unprovoked. When I talk to them, I'll tell you what the problem is. And then the dog bites the new owner. So you adopted the dog out or gave the dog away, and it bites the new owner on the first day. And now the dog is back with you. And now the dog is in your house. If you were a dog trainer, everybody right below, write this on Rumble. Write this on Rumble. Write this on our Facebook and YouTube stream. What is the first question you would ask this client? If I called you up as a client and you were a dog trainer and you specialized in aggression, and I told you that my dog has bitten my children 6 to 8 times, I adopted the dog out and it bit the new owner on the first night and then it came back. What is the first question that me as a trainer would ask you? So take some time, everybody. Right below. Here's some Rumble questions. Good morning, Jeff, and to all of you aspiring dog whisperers. Good morning to you. Just to let you know, I hate the word dog whisperer. It's called being a dog owner. Okay, you don't need a special set of skills to have a happy dog, but I know what you mean by that, so no disrespect at all. You're a dog owner. Every dog owner should have a set of skills that are basic to train their dog. It does not take a special skill. You don't need to be a dog whisperer. You don't have to be a magician. You can do it, but I understand what you meant by that. No disrespect, but I'm trying to change the way that people talk about their dogs. Allison says, good morning. Good morning to you. With affiliate links still being working with a platform switch? Yes, they will. ML560, hey, Jeff, watch on Rumble for the first time. Facebook sucks lately. They're removing so many posts. Yes, they remove all mine. Emil says, oh, this is Kim. Hey, Kim, how are you? Bulldog says, hello, all. Emil says, remove all privileges to you. That's what you would ask them. Allison says, are you prepared to make lifestyle changes necessary to save your dog's life? Would be the first question. So that's all the Rumble questions. Let's go right to Murph. I'm going to give everybody some time to write down the first question they would ask to a client, a potential client that told you that story about their dog. Murph says, happy Monday. Snuggle Bun says, good morning. Melissa says, good morning. Good morning. I put down the link for the Rumble chat, rumble.com/c/solidcaninetraining. And then if you go to our academy, put in academy.solidcaninetraining.com, write in happy 29 as your discount code. And I apologize for everybody that could not get their proper discount and were frustrated with our website, frustrated with us. We were just as frustrated. I assure you, we were just as frustrated. Jojo says, hi, everyone. Moses says, what's going on with the flights and delays? Well, do you want to know what really, really happened? This is what happened. Airlines made pilots get the COVID vaccine. Massive amounts of pilots did not get the COVID vaccine. So now there's a shortage of pilots. Airlines didn't have as many flights. So they put their planes out of commission. So now the airlines are busier than ever, if not busier. Airline flights, every airport I go to now is more. I fly a long time. I flew in the middle of COVID. I flew literally during the lockdown. I was like, there was like three people on the plane. That's why there's a problem right now. And they never recouped from it. But Joelle missed her flight. She didn't miss her flight. The flight was canceled last night. There's been a huge delay this morning. Hopefully she'll make her layover. And Joelle hates flying in general. This is a major trigger for her. Murph says, happy Monday. Let's see. I already read that one. I didn't scroll down. Hi, Jeff. Can I please ask if you're moving the courses to a different platform, are we still going to be able to access those we purchased? Oh, of course you are, Jojo. Absolutely. Oh, absolutely. We're doing this just to make it an easier place to buy courses. Marina says, I love aggressive dogs. That's what I breed. Big, mean dogs. I hope you're not serious. I hope you don't breed mean dogs. Unless you're going to keep them all from yourself, I hope you don't adopt them out. Marino, canine, I hope you're joking. Sid says, what have you done to stop the aggression? That would be the first question you ask. I direct aggression. I'm not sure what that means, but aggression is not something to joke about because dogs end up dead. Families get hurt. This family's already had 6 to 8 bites for their kids. Is your dog muzzled now? And are you immediately seeking a trainer that knows how to correct unwanted behaviors? Mel says, I'm no trainer, but I inquire about the kids we're doing. That dog should not be with that family. Wrong dog. You can't fix everything. Sometimes it's just the dog's personality. I would ask if the dog was provoked by any humans in the house and what happened the first time the dog bit someone and how do they deal with the situation after the bite. Melissa says, answer to question. I know this will be a tough question. Are you ready to have to make the difficult call? You may have to put your dog down humanely. Good morning, Jeff from Cappuccino Dog Training. Good morning. I think it's the first time I've seen you there. Melissa says, yes, delays have been horrible all over. Yes, they have. Flight cancellations have been horrific. Yes. I agree. Camerino dog training. Hey, dear Jeff, what is your opinion on the Keeler method of dog training? It's a great method. Keeler method of dog training is highly, highly, highly effective. Good morning. Thanks for showing how to properly use the prong collar. Yep, I've been doing it for 20 years. I was one of the first people to actually show on social media how to use a prong collar, how to use a remote collar. Everybody else was too much of a wimp. And people in the UK were a massive wimp about it, especially on the remote collars. And look what's happening to you now. And I've been talking about it a long time. Keeler method rocks. That's what I use. Yep. I'm not joking at all. Why would you want to, hopefully you're not Merino canine, hopefully you're not adopting or selling dogs to families. But that's just my opinion. Listening from Australia, I have just found your content over the weekend. I have a 2-year-old Malinois, no training issues, just everything. Watching everyone's different training methods to get my own down better. Good. Justin Cappuccino, I've been on here. Business page. Oh, I get it. Thank you, Justin. Back over to Rumble. Are you prepared to make, let's see, Alice, Amelia says, remove all privileges to you. Are you prepared to take lifestyle changes necessary to save your dog's life? Would be my first question. Bulldog says, I would ask, are you prepared to do everything I tell you to do? Bulldog says, for your dog. Phil at Max has got it, Jeff. Only love and respect for you and all, all on this channel. Thank you. I'm pro all of you. Red Rover dog training says, what are the circumstances around the bites? By the way, this is Sandra King from Canada. Hey, Sandra, how are you? So those are all great questions to ask the owner, and all those questions will be asked of the owner. But if somebody told me their dog had 5 to 6 to 8 bites on their kids, and then it bit an adult male that they rehomed the dog to, the first question I would ask the owner, my snarky response would be, what's the name of your sheetrock repair person? That's what I would ask them. What's the name of your sheetrock repair person? And that's because I'm being semi-sarcastic, but if one of my dogs bit one of my kids, no, I wouldn't throw my dog through a wall, okay? So everybody calm down. But it does go along with, did you rock your dog's world after the first bite? Did you rock your dog's world after the first bite? The issue is people are not. So a lot of people follow me, but if you follow me, then you should know this. So what major uncomfortable consequence did you put on this dog for biting your kids? What major consequence? And this is the problem now, is we're all being brainwashed. We're all being brainwashed by social media. But if a dog starts showing aggression or is being aggressive the first time it does it, there needs to be a high-level consequence. Someone said Rumble's freezing up. Is anybody else having a problem with Rumble today? My apologies if they are. It's not anything I can control on my end. So I'll let you know how the conversation goes. And I don't even know where these folks are located. Yes, I do. But I'm not going to disclose that because I don't want to it's just more of an example. And I get these emails. I get these emails from all over the world. So people can follow me. Hundreds of thousands of people follow me. But what are you doing? What are you doing about it? The problem is people use their hearts more than their heads. But your dog is going to be killed. Your dog is going to be killed. Oh, so Rumble is freezing up this morning. I'm not sure why. I have no idea why. I've got extremely strong bandwidth here. And I'm not quite sure why. So my... wow. So my upload speed is really good. So, first of all, if the dog is resource guarding takes 3 to 5 seconds to stop. I've got free videos on resource guarding. They're on my YouTube channel. We have a resource guarding course. I have 100% success rate on stopping resource guarding. It's not just based around food. It's based around a lot of things. But right off the bat, by reading their email, I can tell them everything that they're doing incorrectly just in the email. And there's probably a lot more. But it's funny because when people say they follow me and then they tell me what the problem is, I'm like, but if you follow me, why are you doing all these things? Everything you're doing goes against everything that I preach. So you're following me. You never know. You never know. Marino says, should have bought a puppy and raised it right. When you adopt dogs, you adopt problems. Sometimes, Marino. I mean, sometimes. But also, a lot of the problem is, Marino, is, as you know this, you train dogs. A lot of people just don't know what to do. They don't know what to do. We've gotten people that have raised, that have gotten puppies, and they end up with aggressive dogs. And is it just the luck of the draw, or do they not know what to do because they were listening to social media about not correcting their dog for unwanted behavior, stopping their dog from aggressive behavior, and now they end up with an aggressive dog? So, and then Cappuccino says genetics matter. Genetics do matter, but the majority of aggressive dogs, I mean, there's been three to six dogs in my 20 years of experience that probably shouldn't be walking the face of the earth. Like, it's like, don't even waste your time rehabbing them. They're just not safe. They're just not safe. But genetics matter a lot in a lot of things. Absolutely. Absolutely. But I think, I honestly think that nurture is more powerful than genetics. Yes, genetics plays an important role. And a lot of times, no matter how well the dog is trained, you're not going to override genetics. Absolutely. But I think if we talked about the bigger picture, and all of the dogs, the aggression that we work with, a lot of it is based just on training. A lot of it's just based on training or lack of. And it's no fault of the owners. They just don't have the right information. So right after this show, I'll be calling these folks up. Actually, no, I won't, because they're in a different time zone. I've got to wait a couple hours. Actually, right after the show, I got to clean the house. Because Joelle's coming back. Not that it's messy. I'm a pretty clean guy, but she likes it spotless. So Angela and I will be vacuuming and mopping. So it's supposed to be beautiful. I think it's going to hit 90 today. I hope she does make her flight. I hope she does make her flight because I think I'm going to force her to go to the beach today. Jet skiing, go to the beach because she'll be stressed out. Marino says, sure, people don't know and they buy the wrong dog. Agreed. Agreed. Murph says, when delivering the intense correction after being bit by a dog is timing everything. I mean, no, the marker is important. The no is important. No, and then consequence. You really want to make sure the word no is powerful. But there's also so much you can do. Is like, why is your dog biting? Most biting can be prevented. Most biting can be prevented. What happens if you can't deliver the correction right away as it was a surprise and the dog isn't wearing an e-collar? There's lots of ways to correct a dog without an e-collar. People have been correcting dogs for 10,000 years without an e-collar. And everybody should know how to do it. And you just go old school. But that, everybody turns that into abuse. But if one of my dogs ever growled or attempted to bite one of my kids or me, it's going to be animal against animal. Animal against animal. Marino says, nope, science says most of our personality is genetic, as much as 80%. Well, first of all, I don't believe in a lot of science. And that's a controversial statement. But second of all, we can all get better. See, this is the thing, Marino, and I'm sure you can relate to this. Have you, or have, and I don't know how old you are, I'm 57. I'm a better human being now than I was 5 years ago. 10 years ago, right? 20 years ago. But my genetics are the same. What changed, Marino? What changed? Me working on myself. Me doing work on myself. Every category of my life, I've been working on myself. And I continue to do working on myself, but I have the same genetics. So, but genetics, I mean, I'm never going to be 6'2". I'm never going to be 6'2". Why? Because genetics. Because genetics says I'm not going to be 6'2". I'm going to be 5'10". Over on Rumble, by the way, Rumble, there's a dollar sign there. You can make a donation on Rumble. Let's see. Bulldog says on Rumble, my Rottweiler thought guarding things was a good idea. Teach her very quickly that that's a big no. Now she's finding great. Learned it from you, Jeff. Thanks. Yeah, you're welcome. Yeah. Resource guarding is quick and efficient. And if you don't know when your dog is going to do it, set it up. We always set it up. We always set it up. Reno says, good topic. Thank you. Kim says, should no always be followed by a consequence? Ideally, yes. And understanding you shouldn't be saying no all day long. Oh, you should rarely have to say no. You should rarely have to say no. Cappuccino says, find a science-based trainer and see how far academia gets you. Exactly. I don't really give a shit if you have a PhD in animal behavior. You know, here's a leash. Here's a leash. Um, Kim says, I absolutely agree with you, Jeffrey. Train the Brain, CBT, Cognitive Behavioral Therapy. There's a great book out there on Cognitive Behavioral Therapy, CBT for Dummies. Everyone should probably read it. Marino says, science isn't about belief. Marino says 57. So Marino, yeah, great example, Marino. So you're 57 years old. So have you or have you not gotten better over the years? Have you been working on yourself? Some people don't. Some people get worse. Some people get worse. But me personally, I've been working on every category of my life and I'm keep getting better. Dog owners have lost their common sense. Yes, Marino says yes, but you can only operate in the parameters of your genetics. We can talk all day long about that, Marino. You know what I mean? I mean, we can talk about all that all day long. I really believe that there are things out there that you can override your genetics. I really believe that. I mean, certain things, no. Certain things, no. But I really believe that you can override some genetic things. But you have to, are we talking about health, behavior, you know, alcoholism, cancer? This can go deep, Marino. I mean, we can go really deep on all of this stuff. But all I know is we get a lot of dogs that are aggressive, and we rehab them, and they end up living happily ever after. Linda says, seems to me that granting the 80%, because who really knows, for the sake of a starting point, 20% is a huge amount of work for behavior or self-improvement. All I know is there's a lot of people out there that are working on their lives to get it better. There's a lot of people. I don't know if it's 80. I don't know if it's 80%. I don't know that. I'm sure you can find it somewhere, but there's a lot of stuff that's written out there, but who knows if it's true or not. Just remember what they said about COVID. COVID was science-based, supposedly. Supposedly. So I'm very skeptical. I'm very, very skeptical about a lot of stuff. Very skeptical about a lot of stuff. I've only gotten better as my genetics will allow. Like I said, Reno, we can talk about a lot about this all day long, but we're not going to. But these are all interesting discussions. I think there's outside influences that have got also a major factor into it as well. A lot of outside influences that have as a major factor as well. Linda says, no, it's a big amount to work with. It's in our favor. Yes. Camarino, dog training is no science. I think dog training is an agenda. I think we have to put that into context. You know, Cappuccino Dogs Training says, COVID puppies are another lie. Dogs who develop behavioral issues were created by those foolish enough to realize there was no need for their dogs to miss out. Yes. Melissa says, agree with outside influences. Yeah. There's so many factors. I mean, I just posted up one of Thomas Sowell's books. I'm sure I'll get a lot of shit for it, which is fine. I just posted up one of Thomas Sowell's books, which I'm working on today. I'm listening to it right now. I do audiobooks. And it's going to really, I'm sure, to ruffle feathers, but people should really listen to it. It's a really, really interesting book. Thomas Sowell is a great, great, great intellectual. And people should, there's a lot of great stuff out there. A lot of great stuff out there about Thomas Sowell. He gets into everything. Everything. He talks about this one book. The book I'm reading right now, listening to right now, is right there. Black Rednecks and White Liberals. Sowell is Sowell. He's got a ton of books out there, and definitely worth reading. But this book is incredible. It talks a lot about we have to remember how new the United States is, and a lot of influences from England, Ireland, Scotland that came over here have got a huge influence on the parallels of early America. One thing he talks about is lynching. When you hear the word lynching, what do you think of? What do you think of? Did you know for about 100 years, guess who was lynched the most? People that look like me. People that look like me. Mm-hmm. Yep. So, but I really wanted to talk about when you have an aggressive dog, you need to find somebody that actually knows how to stop aggression. Stop it cold, stop it in the tracks, and there should be a high-level consequence the first time your dog tries to show aggression or shows aggression. If you don't, the dog will think that it's acceptable. Linda says that word was misused by a politician just this past week. Politicians misuse words? Linda, it can't be true. It cannot be true. No. But that'll be for my separate show on Rumble. It's going to be an exclusive show on Rumble, and I'll be launching it in August. So definitely want to sign up for my Rumble channel, but then there'll be another Rumble channel that I do because it's not going to be associated with Solid Canine Training. It's not going to be associated with Solid Canine Training at all. Don't forget, if you go to our academy right now, and let me get you there right now. Go to the academy, and you buy any of our courses at a minimum, subscribe to our email list for any of our courses. And there's a little notice at the bottom that Tony put up. Happy 29 seems to be working as our discount code. And if you have a problem, just send us a message in the chat. There's a little chat box, and we'll straighten it out. But we're all upset about it. Tony, myself, and Joel are extremely upset because we want to help so many people out, and the platform just didn't pull through, and we're not quite sure why. But this is not the first time it's happened. It's about the third or fourth time it's happened, so we're switching platforms. But that's all it is. Everything stays the same except for it'll be a little bit of a different look and feel, but we have to switch platforms. So that's what's happening with us. Today I'm going to be heading over to the training center to do some more filming with the California 4. Obviously, you're going to catch the replay good. Cappuccino says, got to get to helping the wife. She's yelling to get my ass to work and help with the pups. God bless, Jeff. Good topics. Yep, you better get your ass moving. Melissa says, so many trainers will say they know about aggression and how to fix it, but they don't. Agreed. And then Melissa says, I would never tell anyone of my clients they know how to fix aggression, not in my toolbox. Good. Good. Yeah, people should stay away from aggression rehab if you don't know how to do it, because you might be responsible for the death of a dog when the dog could have actually been rehabbed. And that would not be good. That would not be good. Angelo is going to do his podcast, I think, tomorrow night. Fun Facts with Angelo. I think he's going to be doing it tomorrow night. I'll put the thumbnail up for everybody. But he's excited about that. And the sale's going to run until Tuesday night. Joel is now stuck again. She was overnight. Her flight was canceled from Rhode Island down here. And now she's in Rhode Island. And the morning flight, she's stuck again. So she's not happy. So that'll be interesting for when she gets home. I'll be dealing with that. So I gotta get this house spotless. Spotless. Before she comes home. But I clean really well. We vacuum every day. But today's going to be a deep clean. Mopping, vacuuming, spraying down. Wear arm padding. Oh, I need a full bite suit, Avi. I need a full bite suit. Yeah, should be interesting. All right. Check out our new bundles. We just did a 5-course bundle and a 29% off. It's really, really great. Really, really great. Oh, Bulldog says on Rumble, one angry lady, Joel, I mean. Oh, yeah. Oh, she's furious. Furious. I don't blame her. I'd be pissed off, too. All right, madly in love with all of you guys. Everybody, have a fantastic day. And just wanted to talk about a little bit about aggression. How's Angelo after the jet ski adventure? Oh, he's doing great. He's doing great. Oh, Chris, I'll call you in a little bit, Chris, because I know you emailed me this weekend. And I think you're down for the 22nd. Yep. We just got to talk about time of drop off. So I think you're down. All right, everybody. Everybody have a fantastic day. And I wish you all the best. Gift her with a full massage along with Spotless House. So she, for her birthday, she was gifted with a facial and a massage up in Rhode Island. That's where her masseuse is in Rhode Island. She has to go to a special sports massage person because she's athletic. So she gets a special type. So that's what I got her for her birthday, was a massage and a facial. And her sister is having a boy. They did a gender reveal party. And if you check out Instagram, I held a new baby that's 3 weeks old yesterday. And I guess that would be a nephew of mine. And it was great. I love babies. Yeah. Yep. All right. Everybody take care. Everybody have a fantastic day. Time for me to go. Where the heck is Angelo? Gotta go get his butt out of bed. Kid was exhausted yesterday. He was swimming. He went to his grandfather's house. We went there. We spent the afternoon there. We ran tons of errands. Costco, that'll tire you out, right? Tons of errands yesterday. Obviously, says Mazel Tov, thank you. It's not my kid, but it's a relative's child. And beautiful, beautiful child. So the gift of life is a wonderful thing. It's a wonderful thing. All right. Got to go run. And I'm going to go run the dogs too. I got to run these dogs. Got to run them and then swim them. So we run them hard and then we swim them and then they're good for a little bit. All right. Take care, everybody. I love you all.